Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my larger InDesign course on my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Hi there, in this video we're going to look at bringing in type from Word or an email, or look at typing it in yourself in InDesign. Okay, and we're just going to put in a little bit of text here for our little flyer. So you ready? Let's go and do it. Okay, to add text by yourself, grab the type tool, it's this capital T here, and all you need to do is click hold and drag out a box. Now, like we did with the images, if I start kind of dragging over the top of boxes that I've already made, some weird stuff starts happening. So if I click in here, you can see it's kind of fused this box with that box, and it's kind of a bit weird. It's a weird InDesign quirk. Anyway, so what I'm going to do is have nothing selected, so click in the background, grab my type tool, and what I'm going to do is click hold and drag a box over here on the side. Okay, if you need more room, see these little sliders, okay, we can just move across down the bottom here, and we can start typing. Okay, no, if you can spell helps. Okay, but if I start typing over here, obviously I can put in anything I like. I can grab my black arrow to resize the box to the size it needs to be. Okay, and what I'm going to do is import some text. So I'm going to use this text box. Okay, I'm going to use my black arrow and just move it over here. And what I'm going to do is select all this type, okay, with my type tool, okay, which is the capital T, just delete it all. And I'm going to import some text. There's two ways of doing it. You could do just caveman style, which works perfectly. Okay, I'm going to jump to Word. Actually, let's open the Word document. So it's part of your exercise files. So find your exercise files. Okay, here's mine on my desktop. I've downloaded it under 01 Flyer. There's one in here called Flyer Text. I'm gonna double click and open it. Okay, I'm gonna copy all this text. So I've selected it all, go to Edit, Copy. If you're on a PC, it's slightly different. There's a copy button in the corner, or Control C. Okay, so whatever you do, select it, copy it, and jump back into InDesign. Okay, and in here, I'm gonna paste it. Okay, you can totally do it that way. Okay, and often that's what I do. You might be copying from an email or from anything. Okay, and what you can do though, to be a bit more official and to get a few more options in that copy, is I'm gonna delete it all, have my cursor flashing in here, and I'm gonna go to File, I'm gonna go to Place. Okay, and I've got some text. Okay, so I found my 01 flyer, there's the flyer text. So it just kind of goes around using Word. Okay, so open, and you can see it's dumped it in there. Now the difference between the two is very little in what we're doing, but what you can do and what we'll do later on in my more advanced sections is if we go to File and we go to Place, there's an option here that says Options, and it says Show Import Options. And it means when I bring in my Word document, I get to keep some of the styles that might be in there. Maybe there's a table of contents, that sort of stuff. I'm gonna turn that off and hide that for the moment, but it doesn't really matter how you bring in text as long as we've got some text. Now with my black arrow, I'm gonna drag this box and I'm gonna make the box so it's kind of fits in here appropriately. Okay, within my margins, kind of under the logo here. And what I wanna do is I'm gonna use my type tool. Now you'll notice I don't jump to the type tool, I just kind of double click inside the box and it automatically jumps to the type tool. That's kind of up to you. So I'm gonna select it all and I'm going to do some basic type stuff now. Okay, so if you're happy with formatting type, you might wanna skip along. We're gonna do some of the basics. Okay, so we're gonna pick a font. We're just gonna pick Arial because I know everyone's got Arial. Gotta be able to spell Arial. I'll use Arial bold for bits of it. Okay, I'm gonna select it all again, and along the top here, you've got these two options. Okay, now you might be happy with bold and sizes and stuff, but you'll notice that these two here have very different kind of settings and we need a lot of them. Okay, so I can see on my, it's character and paragraph is the actual names of these. So character has my basic character stuff. Okay, and you can see all the way down here, there's some paragraph stuff. It's only because my screen is very large. If you've got a smaller laptop, you might not be able to see any of these. So you're gonna have to jump to paragraph and you can see, there they are. Okay, so you might have to toggle between these two. So I want to go to the one that says Align Center. Okay, I'm going to highlight this top bit and I'm going to make it my colors over here. I'm going to select the, I'm not going to use dark green at all. I'm actually just going to use white, so which is paper over here. Okay, selected tape paper. I'm going to go back to character. I'm going to make it all caps. Okay, so I'm going to capitalize it all. And in terms of the font size, I'm going to pick a font size. What font size? I don't know. I'm going to go to about there. Okay, so 22 point. Okay, go back to my black arrow, click in the background. It's maybe a little bit close to this, so my black arrow come down a little bit. Couple of things I want to do is I'm going to select this, make it a little bigger. Okay, and I'm going to use my green. Okay, so I'm going to use the mid green. This last kind of URL here, I'm going to select it all, make it, I'm going to leave it the same size, but I'm going to use the dark green. All right, black arrow, click out. And that, my friends, is the basics of importing text. You can either just draw a text box, copy and paste it into it, or you can go to file place, up to you. And we're not going to go through everything like with this font selected here. I'm not going to go through what does subscript and tracking. We'll look at some of the more advanced ones a little bit later on, but there are the basics in here, and everyone knows what, I don't know, right align is and left align, I hope. If you're not sure on some of them, experiment. We will go through more and more as we get through this course. But for the moment now, we've got our font, we've got our text in, we've got some images. Let's get on to our next video. So, what did you think? Did you like it? Okay, if you did, please hit the like button and maybe consider subscribing to my channel. It really helps my business. Now, this is just a free video from my larger InDesign course. You can see the full version on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site, there is a free cheat sheet you can download. Okay, print it off, stick it next to your computer, look awesome. The other thing is I have lots of other courses there. Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, After Effects, Premiere, Dreamweaver, lots of other ones. So go check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye.